Now we're heading south to Latin America, and we're starting in Brazil itself with music from the most celebrated Brazilian composer of them all, Heitor Villa-Lobos. As a boy, Villa-Lobos had a classical music education, but he always loved the sounds of his native Brazil. He traveled all over the country, immersing himself in its rhythms and melodies. And these folk roots were a huge influence on his orchestral writing. This next work, Momoprecoce, is a collection of vivid musical pictures from a children's carnival in Rio. It was originally a solo piano suite, and in the orchestral arrangement we're about to hear, the piano remains a central character. It represents the spirit of Momo, the rotund and jovial king of the carnival. Well, tonight's soloist is legendary pianist Nelson Freire, and we eavesdropped on rehearsal with Marin Alsop and the orchestra earlier today.
The Momoprecoce that we're playing, really it's a children's piece in essence, and it's celebrating children's experience at the carnival, and so it's rather episodic, little vignettes of different situations at carnival. It's very colorful. It's got a lot of lightness and playfulness to it, as you would expect from a piece for children. Well, I'm very excited to work with Nelson. The first time I got to work with him was only a couple of months ago. He's a real poet at the piano. I notice that whenever he wants me to do something, he'll say, "Well, that's the Brazilian way," so that I always have to do it his way. So. To Brazil, Nelson is close to being a football superstar, I would say. I mean, he comes out on stage and people go crazy. So he's a real national treasure.
And here he comes, the Brazilian national treasure pianist Nelson Freire with Marin Alsop to perform Villa-Lobos' Momoprecoce. Nelson Freire playing Villa-Lobos' Momoprecoce with the São Paulo Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Marin Alsop. Momoprecoce is such a vibrant piece. It's all about a thoroughly Brazilian occasion, the carnival of the children in Rio de Janeiro. But actually the piece was orchestrated in Paris. Villa-Lobos had been sent to that epicenter of European musical culture in 1923 on a government grant and with support from various wealthy patrons. And indeed, he became the most successful Latin American composer of his day, arguably even now. Big smiles from Nelson Freire and from the members of the São Paulo Symphony Orchestra as their new principal conductor, Marin Alsop, brings them all to their feet to acknowledge the warm applause from the crowd here at the Albert Hall, which I'd say has a fair contingent of Brazilians in it, as you can see from the flag.